Yeah, thank you so much for having me. I'm happy that I'm no longer the last thing standing between you and lunch, but I will, I'll be quick. So, yes, my name is Elliot. I am a founding engineer at Markprompt. We're based in San Francisco, and we are, I'll talk a little bit more about what we're building, but yes, I did speak in the San Francisco meetup as well, and this will be somewhat of a continuation of the things I was discussing there. So first I'll talk about what we're building at Markprompt, and then mostly I'm going to be talking about our type-safe composable agent framework, obviously built with effects. So this includes things like agents, actions, and then workflows. So how can we build in things that are deterministic and not just leave everything up to the LLM and do that in a very effectful way that is easy for us to move fast? So we're building two main things. One, so we're largely in customer support, customer experience, largely catering towards like developer platforms with high complexity support cases. So working with large-scale LLM processing and analysis systems to provide insights, and then also building highly customizable user-facing LLMs. So these are language models that communicate directly with users that our customers can really customize. So our focuses are on user experience, so things like reliability and latency, and then also developer speed. We're a lean team, and we need tools that are going to allow us to move fast. Our code base is written almost entirely in effect. And a bit about me, I graduated from school in June, and this is like really my first big step in my career. I did not have much TypeScript or effects experience before this, but it's been really fun to jump in, and I'm really glad that I'm using the tooling. So I think a lot of you have probably seen like generally agents. This is kind of like the simplest version of what an agent might be. So something that is able to plan and reason on a task, choose an action and do that, and then feed that back into the system to take another action. So this is kind of a loop. It starts with a user input and it ends with an output to the user. So actions might be something like searching and analyzing logs, getting payment invoices or payment information like invoices. It also might be traditional like RAG, so querying via embeddings or using metadata filters, things like that. And then also, right, this typically ends with a response to the user, whether that's some information or asking for clarification questions. So an action in our system looks like this. You'll notice basically everything I'm showing today has a name and description. This is kind of how the LLM is able to choose what to do. It has some parameters. We use schema to encode these. And then some handler that takes those parameters, parses them, and then returns something. So like I said, it might be something like searching logs, takes a query. You can see the types get propagated here just like we're used to in effect. So we get the error and then the log service. There's no success channel here because the successes are kind of like, they're just strings, at least for now. Another one might be responding, and so how we signal that this should actually go to the user is we set this done flag on the action response to true. This has no requirements, takes no dependencies, no errors. Some of these actions can get quite complicated, and there also might be a lot of actions, so we don't necessarily have control over the number of things that our customers want to be able to give their agents the capabilities to do. So our solution here is subagents. So these are, you can think of as like a team of people that might have different specialties. They each have their own actions, and then one agent will just be able to delegate to another. So instead of just choosing an action and doing it, you actually may invoke a subagent. And so a typical flow might look something like our main agent planning, choosing, doing an action, going back into its loop, and then choosing to invoke a subagent that maybe has a more special purpose, like logging, searching logs, or handling payments. So this one, again, kind of has the same steps. These are all the same, and this is right an inherently recursive system. Oops, sorry. And then it may go back to the main agent and then choose to respond to the user. So this is great. But the question is, should we really leave all this up to chance? You can imagine there are some more deterministic workflows that we want to encode, and we don't want to just give an agent like full autonomy to choose what it's going to do, because most likely, you know, these systems aren't perfect. It's going to choose things wrong some of the time, and we want our customers to be able to control that. So as an example, a user wants to cancel their subscription. A workflow is triggered, and maybe our LLM will ask them why they want to cancel their subscription, and then we'll go get fetch some information from their from an API about it. If it's relevant, we'll try to convince them not to cancel. If it's successful, great, we're done. Otherwise, we do have to cancel the subscription and let them know it's canceled. So this is just one example. This sounds a lot like code execution. So if there was no, if this was not a, you know, a conversation with a user where the user's input is non-deterministic, it would basically just be code execution, right? But in this scenario that I've modeled, we're leaving this up to an LLM. So the solution here is workflows. This is also something that Maxwell talked about in the beginning. Again, workflows have a name and description. This is how a LLM can choose whether or not it wants to trigger it. And then just like the other things, it has the action return, so it returns the same thing that an action does, unifying the interface, and then it has a bunch of errors and a bunch of requirements. So we would model this as a cancel subscription workflow, and it takes a name and description, and also a flow. So this is what a flow looks like. This is something that I've built internally. It's kind of a DSL for building these deterministic workflows with some with being able to handle non-deterministic input from users. So as you can see, this kind of looks a lot like an effect pipe. We are using the effect piping mechanism, and I'll kind of show a little bit of what this looks like behind the scenes, and then I'll go more into what this flow does. So what is a flow? The interface here is just something that basically can be executed, and it returns an effect. Very simple, returns this like flow intermediate result. It's not very important, and has some errors and requirements. And it also depends on some the state of the agent. And then I just have kind of aliased this to like flow wrap to make it a little bit easier to read in the presentation. So this is just an effect that returns a flow. So there's a few things. This is how we compose flows. So the first thing we do is we kind of lift an action into the flow ecosystem. Very simple, just takes an action, returns a flow. Then we have and then, which takes a previous flow, and then takes an action, which returns a function that takes a previous flow and returns a new one. So this is how we can start to actually pipe these things together and how this actually becomes a DSL. And then we have things like, you can kind of think of this very similar to effect.if, it's flow.doif. So it takes a condition, and then takes a true and false based on that condition. Right now, conditions are just gonna be strings. And it is able to actually propagate all the types. So there's kind of a lot of type stuff going on here, but it's basically just propagating all of the true and false types through to the final flow that's returned. And then there's a no-op flow, which is just a utility that I'll show in a moment. It literally just returns the previous flow. So to go through this cancel subscription flow, we first ask the user for the cancellation reason, and then we get the subscription details. If the user has only been subscribed for 1 month, we do something, otherwise we do something else. And so this is where we use an LLM to actually work in the non-deterministic input from the user, and there's a lot of kind of stuff happening behind the scenes in this flow module that is allows it to eject and retry steps, but this allows us to basically just create these things very easily as developers and allow our users to create them in a way that allows us to combine the non-determinism of agents with the determinism of workflows. So the cancel subscription flow, again, gets all those error states piped through. So why is this a good solution? First, it's modular. We can create new flow, you know, utilities, like you can imagine flow.all or something, very similar effect, where we're able to just execute a bunch of steps in parallel, and all of this stuff is contained within those functions. It's not contained in some executor that has to manage every single type of these things, right? We're not managing a graph, everything is self-managed. It's also type safe, just like the rest of effect. So putting it all together, we have an agent, it may have sub-agents, and it may also have workflows. All of these things are unified into a single decision-making interface, and then they're just the state is handled internally. So this is what an agent looks like. Again, name and description, has the errors and the requirements propagated. So we can create a logging agent, those slides are backwards. We can create a logging agent, and then we can create our main agent, that has the logging agent, has a workflow, and all of these types get propagated through. And so in this naturally recursive ecosystem, we can actually get all of these types propagated. And this is the really, really nice thing here about effect, is that all of this, you're not just dealing with this like jumbled mess of things that can happen. You know exactly on the output of this what can happen. So just very quickly to recap, these LLM systems are very inherently complex and non-deterministic. And it can be easy to kind of build these simple cases. There's, you know, it's pretty fast to get a prototype of these agents up and running, but it can get really messy when your customers start to have 10, 20 things that they want them to be able to do. And it's really nice with Effect to be able to break these things down and provide ways for your customers to be sure that what they want is going to happen is actually going to happen. All right, this is this point here. So we still have a lot to do, but I think that the moral of the story is we're very confident that we're building the right tools. It's very nice to be able to create these DSLs, use the primitives that Effect has already created to write code that really just fits very well within the rest of our system. Yeah, so thank you. And this is my contact info. I'd love to talk if you're interested in this kind of stuff. And yeah, I really appreciate everybody watching and being here and the Effect team for having me. Thank you.